Good morning and happy Saturday. It's about 10 minutes to 7. That's why it's still super dark out. Oh, I miss summer and it getting light out at 5 a.m. But I just pulled into the grocery store. I'm currently at Fred Meyer. I'm going to be doing quite the haul this week. I will have Walmart, Fred Meyer, and Costco. So I have quite the haul coming your way. Also, I'll be sharing with you what I'm doing for meal prep. I can't wait for this week's recipes. And I'm also going to be sharing with you my plan for dinners for the week. Now, a lot of you have reached out and asked what my plans are for the Thanksgiving holiday as far as WW goes. Am I staying on track? Am I going to enjoy myself? In my weigh-in video yesterday, I talked all about Thanksgiving and what my plan was. So definitely check out that video. It was just my regular weigh-in video. It was posted yesterday. So check that out and you'll get all of your questions answered as far as what my plans are for the Thanksgiving holiday. So I'm going to head into Fred Meyer and do some grocery shopping. Stay tuned for my meal plan, my meal prep, and my huge grocery haul for the week. So here is my haul from Fred Meyer, which is also a Kroger store. And then we will get into what I picked up from Trader Joe's. So actually, I ended up going to 4 stores instead of 3. So let me first show you what is in my haul from Fred Meyer for the week. I went ahead and grabbed some more almond milk. I really like this Califia Farms Toasted Coconut Almond Milk. It is so good. It's creamy. It has really good flavor with that little bit of a hint of coconut. So if you are a fan of coconut, you would really, really enjoy this almond milk. I also grabbed some sour cream with chives. This is just your traditional sour cream. This is actually for Thanksgiving. I put sour cream in my mashed potatoes, so I picked that up. I thought the accent of chives would be really good. And then I also grabbed some low-fat cottage cheese. This was on a killer deal, $1.69, and it's the Simple Truth organic low-fat cottage cheese. I've been on a big cottage cheese kick, so I thought I would pick up just another small one because it was such a good deal. Also, of course, 2 more containers of my sugar-free peppermint mocha. If you don't watch my grocery hauls or you miss this part, I do freeze these. You just throw these in your freezer, you pull them out, you let them defrost, and they become perfect creamer again. And you can have all of your favorite holiday flavors all year long. So I love the sugar-free peppermint mocha. It is my all-time favorite. And these, you guys, were on sale at Fred Meyer, or if you have a Fred Meyer or Kroger near you, for $1.99, which is a fabulous deal. And there's a digital coupon for $1 off. So I actually paid $3 for both of these, which is a steal. So I have those, they'll go into my freezer. Eggs, of course, the Happy Eggs, as you know, those are my very, very favorite. So I picked those up to have those for breakfast meal prep and then just for snacking. Center cut bacon, this is for my breakfast meal prep. Wait until you guys see what I'm making. I'm super excited. I love the Private Selection brand. It is a Fred Meyer brand. You can have 2 slices of this bacon for 1 smart point. So I love that. Also some turkey pepperoni. I'm going to be making some English muffin pizzas in the oven. I can't wait to have those. It's just a great way to have pizza for low points. So turkey pepperoni is for that. Also some peppered turkey breast. I've been loving wraps for lunch on the weekends, like I made in my meal prep with the bacon and the avocado turkey. So I picked up some of the peppered turkey. You can see the little flakes of pepper. So good. I'm excited for some wraps. And then string cheese, this is for my husband, just regular low moisture, part skim, mozzarella cheese sticks. For meat this week, I grabbed a pound of 96.4 extra lean ground beef for a recipe. Also, my favorite thing, and I've only seen this at Fred Meyer, so if you've seen this anywhere else, comment down below and let everybody know, but I've seen this only at my Fred Meyer store, and this is the shaved steak. This is ideal, ideal, you guys, for Philly cheesesteak sandwiches. It is the perfect thinness and texture and everything. So I picked that up because we are having Philly cheesesteaks this week. So pick this up if you can score it at your local Fred Meyer or Kroger store. And then I grabbed this just to throw in the freezer because look at the price of this. This is a huge roast, boneless roast. So it's got a lot less fat than the bone-in roast. And this whole roast was only $8.61. And this is almost 3 pounds. So I'm gonna throw this in the freezer. It'll be great to have on hand for a good pot roast in the pot roast recipe, if I can speak, in either the crock pot or the instant pot. So that's just going into the freezer. fat-free Ready Whip. I was out this week and very saddened by the fact that I was out, so I picked that up. In the back here, I have two containers of the Duncan Hines Creamy Frosting. Of course, not the best on WW, but I'm making a cake for Thanksgiving. I'm gonna do a homemade white cake with some cream cheese frosting and some fun Thanksgiving sprinkles. I'll make sure that I post a picture on Instagram or something so you guys can see it, but I picked up two containers of frosting for that. For my cake recipe, as well as for my mashed potatoes for Thanksgiving, some whole milk. I don't drink milk at all, and my husband prefers 1%, but I needed whole milk for the recipe, so I just got this small one. I figure he can probably just finish off whatever is left, which actually probably won't be much. So some whole milk for some recipes. Vegetable broth for an upcoming dinner recipe. I picked up some more oat flour. I was completely out, and I use this in a lot of baking recipes. In fact, I need it for meal prep. Some gnocchi, some Italian gnocchi. The recipe actually called for ricotta gnocchi, and I couldn't find that. They had basil pesto and a couple others, but this was the lowest points, and this is just your traditional Italian gnocchi. So I'm just subbing this into the recipe. I don't know that you'll even notice the difference. Crisco, this is for my cake recipe. So, and also with Christmas coming up, having shortening on hand is always a good thing. Bread, I just picked up buttermilk this week. This bread is only 3 smart points per slice. So if you're not a huge fan of low calorie, cardboardy, thin bread, this is a good option. And it is only 3 smart points per slice. So that is not bad. Also some Italian herb and garlic sub rolls. I scanned these in the store and these were the lowest points. These are only 5 points, which is not bad for a hoagie roll. And I'm gonna be using these with the Philly cheesesteak sandwiches. So if you have this brand at your store, these look amazing with all those spices. So this is for the Philly cheese. And then also I saw these and these were only $1.99 and I picked them up for Christmas. So I'm gonna be making a chocolate chip cookie, but I'm subbing out the chocolate chips for these sea salt caramel filled baking truffles. So look at those, yum. So I'm gonna be making that for Christmas. Of course, it wouldn't be WW friendly, but this is just for friends and family on Christmas. So I'm just gonna toss those in the pantry. And then you know I've been loving my Siggy's yogurt. So I went ahead and picked up 3 more. I love this yogurt. It is 1 point more than the Dan Enlightened Fit, but the ingredients in this yogurt are amazing. So all that is in here is pasteurized skim milk, blueberries, cane sugar, fruit pectin, and live active cultures. That's it. So no artificial sweeteners, nothing, and they're only 3 points. As long as you get the one that says 0% milk fat, so watch that. They all look the same, and some of them are 2% milk fat, and that makes them 5 points, or the whole milk ones are 9 points. So just watch this little bit right here when you're picking up Siggy. So I have blueberry, and then I have raspberry. Oops, I'll spin ya. And I have, this one sounds really good, mixed berries and acai. So I picked those up just to have on hand for the week. The rest is produce and veggies. So I've got some Private Selection hard-cut vert green beans, however you pronounce that, basically green beans. This brand of frozen vegetables is my favorite. Besides the Pick Me or Pick Sweet, I really like this brand as well, and I had a great coupon, so I grabbed some green beans. 3 red potatoes for a recipe. Asparagus for a recipe, mushrooms for a recipe, and lastly, 3 bell peppers, red, orange, and green for those Philly cheesesteak sandwiches. So that's everything that I picked up this week at Fred Meyer. Now let's get into Trader Joe's. And here are just a few things I picked up at Trader Joe's. I just needed a couple of things. I did haul some holiday things that you'll be seeing in an upcoming video, but for the week, this is what I picked up. So first I grabbed I'm a big bag of Trader Joe's gold potatoes for Thanksgiving. I'm in charge of the mashed potatoes. And then also I just got one extra one just in case. I wasn't sure if this would be enough and I didn't want to buy 2 bags and have too much mashed potatoes. So I just grabbed one more of those. And you know I love the sprouted wheat sourdough bread. So I picked that up just to have on hand for sandwiches, toast. I love this bread so much. It's so good. It is packed full of protein, so it actually keeps you full. There is 7 grams of protein per slice. So amazing. And it is so hearty and delicious. A package of broccoli. This is for an upcoming recipe. Also some leeks, and this is for an upcoming recipe. I really like leeks, and it's a vegetable that I don't think to buy very often. So I definitely need to get it back on my radar because I actually do really like leeks. And then a couple of Pink Lady apples for a recipe. And then these are a new apple and the flesh of these is pink. So very interesting. They are a little bit tart. So I will show you those in an upcoming video, maybe of what I eat in a day. But I picked a couple of those up just to try those. So that's everything for the week from Trader Joe's. So here's my small Walmart haul. I just did grocery pickup just for a few of my favorite Walmart groceries. So let me show you what I picked up from Walmart grocery pickup. I grabbed a 24 pack of Diet Coke for my husband. He made a vow that as of his birthday, he was going to cut back on his Diet Coke. And his birthday was last week and I have not seen a cutback. So we should probably revisit that topic, shall we? So anyways, I picked up a 24 pack for him. Also, I wanted to show these to you guys. He loves these in his lunch. So I wanted to show you the Smart Points. It's insane for this tiny little packet of cookies. So he loves these. I always pick these up at Walmart. Fred Meyer does not sell them. He likes them in his lunch. These are also for his lunch, but I wanted to show these to you as well because these are actually not too terrible on points. So you can definitely work these into your day if you're a chip person. And what's great about them is they're pre-portioned, so you don't overeat. Unless, of course, you go back for a second bag. But if you just take one bag with you, you don't overeat the chips. I also got some low-fat cottage cheese. I don't know what it is, but I've been craving cottage cheese. Daisy 2% is my favorite. And then 'tis the season of holiday baking. So I picked up this adorable little sprinkle mix, all the fun Christmas colors. I make sugar cookies, and then of course there'll be some WW-friendly baking videos coming your way. This is our favorite mac and cheese. We love to have this for dinner as a side. You can pair this with chicken if you're following blue for 0 points, or for me on the green plan, it is still really, really low in points chicken, so I could pair this with some chicken. And then I grabbed some more fat-free cheese, mozzarella, and cheddar, only because Fred Meyer does not carry fat-free cheese. And then the last thing is this creme brulee coffee. I have to say, this is my very favorite coffee from Walmart. I love this, and it's like $4. I have a French press, so when I'm not making espresso and I just want that little extra cup of coffee, this creme brulee is amazing. So I went ahead and picked that up. So that's everything from Walmart. So here is my haul from Costco. So I had a haul there as well. I try to go to Costco 1 to 2 times a month and I did need to get a few things. So I went ahead and picked up some staples and then a few fun things that I found along the way. My favorite bottled water hands down is Costco. I don't know why. It's my all-time favorite. So I picked up a 40 pack of the bottled water. Restocked on another staple in my house, the Costco kitchen bags. So we were out and we bought them at the store. I don't like the store ones. I've decided that my very favorite, hands down, are the Kirkland kitchen bags. Love them. So stocked up on 2 big rolls of those. Raspberries were $4.49, which is not bad because they are out of season. And then blueberries were just a little over $5. And again, out of season. So I picked those up for fruit for the week. And then they had some dog treats on sale. And those of you that follow my channel know that my babies can't have chicken or grain. So it is sometimes hard to find dog treats for them. So I found these Nylabone grain-free with real bison edible dog chew. So all that's in here for protein is bison. And there's 48 of them. And I want to say this was $11 on sale. So not bad at all. This is what the chews look like if you're interested in picking them up for your pup. And then also that I found these 100% rawhide free from the brand Cadet, which I actually really like this brand, a 40 pack of the gourmet pork hide chews. These are also grain free and the only meat in these is pork and they look like these rolls. So I think my dogs will really like those. And both of these dog treats were just about $11, so a steal. Picked up some acid controller. Now that they took Zantac off the market, that's what my husband and I used to use for heartburn. So they do still carry the Kirkland brand, which is somewhat like Pepcid AC. So I'm gonna try this. I'm hoping it works as well as Zantac did. And this was really inexpensive, just about $11, I think, for 2 containers. Minced garlic, another thing I always, always buy at Costco. $4.79 for this huge thing, and it's delicious. And the last one I bought, we already went through, which is crazy to me. So grab that. Big bag of avocados, $5.99, and there are 7 avocados. I'm gonna start incorporating a lot of avocado into my eating, so I know I'll go through this in the next week or so. I found this really cute flannel shirt. You saw a lot of you commented actually on my video where I wore that reddish orangish flannel shirt, how cute it was, and I love that shirt. This one is very soft. This is from Costco and I got it for $9.99. So I thought this would be really cute with like a white tank and some black jeans. So picked that up. Of course, chicken, that is one thing I buy at Costco every single trip, is the boneless, skinless chicken breast. I like these because you just cut here on the seam and you have packs of two or so chicken breasts. So it's perfect. And there are six packages and it was $21. So not bad at all. Also, I grabbed cooking spray because when I got to Costco, I couldn't remember if we had a backup. And now that it's propellant free, I've been loving the canola oil spray. Of course, vitamins for me. These are the VitaFusion Multivites. These were $9 on sale. I love the VitaFusion brand, so I picked those up. And lastly, a 3-pack of the Crest Pro Health Advanced Whitening Stronger Teeth for a Healthier Smile Deep Clean Mouthwash. So there's a 3-pack of that. So that's everything I picked up at Costco. My bill was $158. So not bad considering. So that was my Costco haul for the next couple of weeks. Let's get into this week's meal plan and what I am doing this week for meal prep. This, of course, is my Carrie L meal planner. Super exciting news on the Carrie L front. They are coming out with their 2020 meal planners. They are going to change the covers, change the format. I'm so excited. They should be out on the Carrie L website hopefully this weekend. So the link for Carrie L is down below. I do have 10% off of the Carrie L meal planner as well. So check out the link down below, check out their website, and make sure that they have their new planners on there. You can use my discount for the spiral bound large or small planner, as well as any of the digital versions of the planners. You guys know I love these. So I'm gonna just really quickly run through the tabs because I don't know if they're changing that as well. But the resources tab is basically where you can log your favorite recipe, meal planning sites, blogs, etc. The inventory tab, of course, is to inventory everything from your freezer to your pantry and also to your spices. And then the meal plans tab, we'll come back to that. Gatherings, this is coming in super handy this time of year. Mine is actually missing for Thanksgiving, but you can plan your events. You can plan all your food, also what you're doing for kids, supplies, and then there's a detachable grocery list to take to the store. There's a notes tab where you can write down notes or recipes or anything that you want to keep track of. And then in the back is a cute little two-sided kind of pocket folder. So let's go back to the meal plans tab. That's where we're gonna spend some time. Under the meal plan tab, you can see here that there is a monthly at a glance calendar. I love this because you can jot down what you're planning to make for the week as far as your recipes go. The night before, you can make sure that you have your meat out of the freezer and you have all of the ingredients on hand. So it just makes it really easy and at a glance. I love this. I use this every single month, as you can see, to kind of plan out my meals. And then each week there is a weekly menu and you can plan all of your meals if you'd like: breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks. I generally just plan dinner because I do meal prep. So I eat the same thing for breakfast and lunches throughout the week, but I do plan my dinners. And then every week I use my detachable grocery list. And that's actually what I take with me to the grocery store. So it's just awesome. I love this planner. It is so beautiful and comprehensive. Definitely a must-have on this journey, in my opinion. So let's jump into this week. So this is the week we're currently in. You can see my grocery list is missing. So my week goes from Saturday through Friday. So today is Saturday. I have out to dinner here. However, it dawned on me after I planned my meals that Thanksgiving is Thursday. So I need to save my weeklies for that. So I'll be making something for dinner tonight. I'm just not sure what that is, but it will definitely be WW friendly. And I'm going to be saving my weeklies for Thanksgiving. So tomorrow night, Sunday, I'm going to be making English muffin pizza. So just kind of a fun spin on your traditional pizza. Monday is chicken noodle soup, which I'm so excited about. It's definitely cold here. It was in the low 30s this morning. So I'm gonna be doing that and maybe pair that with some bread or some biscuits. Tuesday will be leftovers because I actually go to Jazzercise on Tuesday nights. Wednesday, I'm gonna be making Philly cheesesteaks and veggies in my Instant Pot. Can't wait for that. Thursday, my friends, is Thanksgiving. So happy Thanksgiving to you and your family. And lastly, on Friday, I am back on track on Friday, so you can see I have a meal planned. I'll be making some vegetarian pot pies. So this is what's in store for dinners for the week. And then let's talk meal prep. Now, of course, you guys will be seeing this on Monday, which is Meal Prep Monday. For breakfast this week, I'm so excited. I am making bacon, egg, and cheese chaffles, you guys. How fun is this going to be? I'm gonna probably pair this with some fruit. I am so excited. I love chaffles, and I'm gonna put my own little spin on it, so definitely stay tuned for that. For lunch, I'm gonna be making chicken sausage gnocchi skillet. So I'm gonna be getting some protein, some gnocchi, some yumminess of that, some veggies, and I'll probably pair that with a fruit as well. And then I am excited about this. I'm going to be making cider glazed apple pie bars. Doesn't that sound so good? So you guys will be seeing all three of these recipes in Meal Prep Monday. So that's what's on the plan for the week. And again, you guys, my Carryall meal planner, I am going to go ahead and put my discount code here on the screen for you. Definitely stay on their website until they bring out the new versions. I'm going to order one as soon as they are released. So highly recommend, save 10% and pick yourself up a Carryall meal planner. Thank you for joining me on another weekly WW grocery haul and my meal plan and my meal prep for the week. It was a huge haul between Walmart, Fred Meyer, Trader Joe's, and Costco, but we are stocked up, ready for the week, ready for Thanksgiving. So if you're new to my channel, make sure you take a moment and subscribe. I'd love to have you be part of my YouTube friends and family. Make sure you hit that little notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Thumbs up this video if you like grocery hauls, and of course, comment down below and let me know what was your favorite thing I picked up for the week. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!